Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our SMission YouTube channel. Myself, Mrs. Bhamre ma'am, and in our last video, we have learned the lesson number 1.3, that is the call of the soil, a scent of rice, in which we have finished the first part of the lesson, that is the first crop. In that first part, we have learned about the writer's first experience as a farmer. Not only a farmer, but a successful farmer, we can say. In that part, we learned that how writer become confident about his farming activities, about his decisions, about his land. He got the first crop of moong, that is of green gram, without using any kind of chemical, any kind of pesticides. He got 300 kilograms of moong, and that was his success. In fact, he insisted on doing organic farming as well. As he convinced other farmers also to grow the organic crop. So in the first part, we have learned about his first experience of the first crop without any chemical, and that crop, that ill, boost his confidence on himself as well as on his land. In today's video, we are going to start the next part, that is the scent of rice. See, the title, the scent of rice, tells us that in this part we are going to learn about his next crop, that is of rice. Students, as we all know, there are so many varieties of rice in our India. In fact, so many new varieties are there. New varieties are invented by so many farmers. And old varieties are disappeared. As we read the title, The Scent of Rice, that remember us the true scent of rice. Students, as we all know, Nandurbar is the district of Adivasi people, and with Adivasi people, with this name, we remember the rice they grow, that is scented rice, old variety of rice, which is getting disappeared slowly in other parts of India. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, आपला नंदुरबार जिल्हा हा आदिवासी जिल्हा आहे, आणि आपल्याला सर्वांनाच माहिती आहे की या जिल्ह्यामध्ये हा सेंटेड राईस पिकवला जातो, याचं पीक घेतलं जातं. जे आदिवासी लोक आहेत ती अजूनही या जुन्या व्हरायटीचं पीक घेतात, है ना, तांदळाची जुनी व्हरायटी, जी भारतातल्या इतर भागांमध्ये आपल्याला कुठेही दिसत नाही. आणि हे नाव ऐकता बरोबर, द सेंट ऑफ राईस, हे टायटल वाचताच आपल्याला त्या राईसचा सेंट आठवतो. सो इन दिस पार्ट वी विल लर्न अबाउट द रायटर्स स्ट्रगल टू फाइंड द ओल्ड व्हरायटी ऑफ राईस अँड वॉट वॉज द नेम ऑफ दॅट व्हरायटी वी विल लर्न इन दिस व्हिडिओ. ओके, सो लेट स्टार्ट द लेसन. Come to the next part. Last two lines are there. Open your textbook and open the page number 27. See the last two lines of page number 27. The first year I was late for rice sowing season and had to resort to growing the GR4 variety that was short term and recommended by the agricultural officers at Kosbad. Actually, that was the first year and he was late for rice sowing season. So, someone suggested him to sow the GR4 variety of rice as he was already late and this variety was short term, means it took a short time. This crop need, this type of rice need short time to get ripe, and that suggestion was given by the agricultural officer at Kosbad. So, the next year, we decided that we would start early and try to find some good traditional variety of rice to grow. So, what did they decide? They decided that in the next year, they would start as early as possible and try to find some good traditional variety of rice to grow. In fact, they were in search of old variety of rice, old traditional variety of rice that was getting disappeared. Of course, old is gold, as we all know. And really, the old crop, old yield, the taste of that old crop was really different. In fact, the taste of soil, taste of land was different. So, the taste of crop was also different. Taste of that grains was also different. All kind of grain, whether it is wheat, bajra, jowar, everything. Today's taste is totally different as the land is tasteless because of too much use of chemicals, pesticides that affect the crop, and of course indirectly that affect our health. So let's come to the point. So they decided to find some good traditional variety of rice. We had read about traditional varieties of rice and knew that they did not require very high inputs of fertilizers. Actually, the writer had already read about such traditional varieties of rice and he was very well known about that variety that it did not require very high inputs of fertilizers. So, these varieties were also quite strong and resistant pest. Why he was insisting to grow the old traditional variety of rice? Because that varieties were strong enough to resist the pest. Ya varieties kasha hotya? Strong enough to resist the pest. Manje je pest astat, kitaks vagare. यांच्याशी ते फाईट करू शकणाऱ्या व्हरायटीज आहेत. वी वे शुअर दॅट इट वॉज दिस टाईप ऑफ राईस दॅट वूड ग्रो वेल इन अवर फार्म वेअर वी डीड नॉट यूज एनी केमिकल्स ॲट ऑल. ॲक्च्युली ॲज इन अवर फर्स्ट पार्ट
we have learned that he got confident about his land also, and so he thinks that we were sure that it was this type of rice that would grow well in our farm where we did not use any chemicals at all. He was confident, he was sure that this type of rice would grow well in their land, in their farm, where they do not want to use any type of chemical at all. Our previous year's experience and low yield had taught us a lesson, and we were sure we would not plant hybrids this year. Actually, their previous year's experience was a different one. And low yield had taught us a lesson, as we have learned in first line that they saw GR4 rice and that gave low yield, and that taught us the lesson that we were sure we would not plant hybrids this year. Actually, GR4 is a hybrid type of variety of rice. So they decided not to plant hybrids this year. Now let's come to the next paragraph. In April 2005, we started to look for a good variety of traditional rice, and it was one of our neighbors in our village, a businessman from Mumbai who owned land, who suggested that we plant a local scented variety of rice. In April 2005, they started looking for a good traditional variety of rice. Actually, it was really difficult for him at that time to find the seed of old traditional rice. It was one of our neighbors in the village who was a good businessman from Mumbai. He also owned land in that village, and that man suggested them to plant the local scented variety of rice. Local scented variety, as I told you about our Nandurbar district, hai na, apla Nandurbar district vishay mi tumhala sangitla, where most of the Adivasi people plant the local scented variety of rice which we got in our Mangal Bazar, je aplyala Mangal Bazarat bhettat te rice. And see, according to their suggestion, they started finding the old traditional variety of rice. Let's see. Most of the farmers in and around the village of Pet had switched over to hybrids. Actually, what happened that most of the farmers in that village or around the village of Pet, they switched over to hybrids. To switch over means what? To stop doing one thing and started another thing. You know, they stopped planting the old traditional variety of rice. In fact, they switched over to hybrids. They started planting hybrid variety of rice. And the younger generation of farmers thought I was crazy to ask for the desi variety. In fact, as I told you, in April 2005, writers started looking for the desi variety of rice. Desi means what? Traditional variety of rice. When he was in search of that variety of rice, the younger generation of farmers from that village or around that village, they thought that writer was crazy, mad, who is asking for the desi variety. See, my regular visits to the village around searching for a good traditional variety also did not yield any result, and we were almost giving up hope. In fact, he was visiting regularly to near about villages in search of traditional variety, traditional seed of rice. And he did not get any result. So they almost giving up the hope. त्यांनी आशा सोडली होती. See, this is the struggle of writer just to find out the seed of old traditional variety of rice. फक्त ते बियाणं मिळवण्यासाठी त्यांनी किंवा ओल्ड ट्रॅडिशनल राईस कुठला आहे ते सर्च करण्यासाठी त्यांनी एवढं स्ट्रगल केलं. लेट सी. I decided to give it one last try and spoke to Babban's father and some other elders. After many meaningful conversations, they mentioned the name of Kasbai. So, writer decided to give the last try, last chance, and he spoke to Babban's father and some other elder people of that village or village. All the people from around village, near about village. And after so many conversations, most of the people mentioned the name of Kasbai rice. Of course, Kasbai is a traditional long grain rice variety which has a distinct aroma, though much milder than basmati. We all know the aroma of basmati. But Kasbai has milder aroma than basmati, but that is long grain rice, long grain variety of rice. It's a long duration crop and most of the older people remembered growing it years ago. Actually, here we got the reason that why most of the people stop growing this old traditional variety of rice, that is Kasbai, because it's a long duration crop. He crop kasa ahe? Long duration crop ahe. Mhanje ya he pik ghena sathi lagnara vel ha jast ahe. Ani mhanun atachi young generation ahe. In opposite to this crop, hybrid varieties of rice are short duration crop. So आत्ताची यंग जनरेशन जी आहे ते हायब्रिड्सचं पीक घेतात बिकॉज इट्स शॉर्ट ड्युरेशन क्रॉप. ॲज कसबाई इज अ लाँग ड्युरेशन क्रॉप, दिस टाईप ऑफ राईस, दिस व्हरायटी ऑफ राईस इज गेटिंग डिसअपियर्ड. अँड मोस्ट ऑफ द ओल्डर पीपल रिमेंबर्ड ग्रोविंग इट इयर्स अगो. So many years ago, old people remember that the rice was growing so many years ago. But they all shook their heads when I asked them about the seeds and told me that it had disappeared. When writer asked them about the seed of that rice, they shook their head and told him that it had disappeared totally. The taste of Kasbai made us more determined to get it now. He became more eager to get the seed of that variety of rice. Whatever he heard about Kasbai, he became more eager now. That made us more determined to get it. And see, we decided that if we did manage to get some seeds, this would be a great rice to grow. What did they decide? They decided that if they got at least some seeds, this would be a great rice to grow. I thought the government may know something about it. He thought so. That government officer will give him some information about that rice. A visit to agricultural officer was enlightening. Actually, when he visited the then agricultural officer of that village, His visit was really enlightening. Enlightening means what? That gave him greater knowledge and understanding about that variety. In fact, whatever knowledge he got, that was shocking. See, he had not even heard of this rice variety. When he heard from that officer that he did not even heard about the name of that variety of rice, the writer was shocked. He said, "The villagers were taking me for a ride and there was no rice by this name." See, what did he say? He said that villagers are, he said that the villagers were taking me for a ride and there was no rice. To take someone for a ride means what? To deceive or cheat someone. आपण म्हणतो ना की दिशाभूल करणं, एखाद्याला फसवणं. सो ऑफिसर थॉट सो. ही रॅटल ऑफ द नेम्स ऑफ अ नंबर ऑफ लेटेस्ट हायब्रिड्स अँड इवन ऑफर टू गिव्ह सम ऑफ देम फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट फॉर अ ट्रायल. ॲक्च्युली ही रॅटल ऑफ मीन्स वॉट? ही टॉक्ड रॅपिडली अबाउट वॉट? The number of latest hybrid varieties of rice, and even offered him some of them free of cost for trial. Agdi free of cost tani offer keli, but which varieties? Hybrids. And which writer did not want to grow in his field? Cursing myself for wasting time with him, I moved on to the next destination. So, actually he cursed himself for wasting time with that agricultural officer who even did not heard the name of that variety. And then writer moved to the next destination. Writer la atati व्हरायटी सर्च करायची, ते सीड मिळवायचे म्हणून त्याचे प्रयत्न चाललेत. हिज विजिट टू दॅट ॲग्रिकल्चर ऑफिसर वॉज द वेस्टेज ऑफ टाईम. सो विच वॉज द नेक्स्ट डेस्टिनेशन ऑफ रायटर? लेट्स सी. दिस टाईम इट वॉज द आदिवासी महामंडळ ॲट कासा विच बायज राईस फ्रॉम द आदिवासी विलेजर्स ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द गव्हर्नमेंट. सो दिस टाईम his visit was to with the Adivasi Mahamandal at Kasa. Tani kunala visit dili? Adivasi Mahamandal. Kasa yancha je Adivasi Mahamandal ahe. Which buys rice from the Adivasi villagers. Je kuna kodun rice ghetat? Adivasi villagers kodun rice ghetat on behalf of the government. And Kasbai did not figure in their files. There also he become nervous because in their files they did not find the name of Kasbai rice. A good indication why people did not grow it anymore. That was the good indication that why people did not grow that rice anymore. The market itself did not recognize the rice. नुसतं बाजारात सुद्धा तो राईस ओळखला जात नाही. सो इफ यू ग्रीव इट यू वुड नॉट बी एबल टू सेल इट. आणि म्हणून जर बाजारातच त्या राईसची ओळख नाही आहे तर तुम्ही तो राईस पिकवला तरीही त्याला विकणं कसं आहे? अवघड असणार आहे. हवेवर द ऑफिसर इन चार्ज हिअर हॅज मोर नॉलेज ऑफ राईस अँड डीड रिमेंबर कसबाई बीइंग सोल्ड टू हिम अ फ्यू इयर्स अगो. बट the officer in charge had some knowledge about that rice. He had heard the name of that rice and even today he remembered that Kasbai being sold to him few years ago. अजूनही त्याला आठवतंय की हा जो राईस होता कसबाई राईस तो काही वर्षांपूर्वी विकला जात होता. He remembered that. So here, writer got some clue about that rice. So, students, in this video, we learn about writer's struggle to find the traditional variety of rice. In fact, his struggle has not yet finished. अजूनपर्यंत त्याचा struggle संपलेला नाहीये. It's going on. And in our next video, we will learn how he got the seed for Kasbai rice. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Have a nice day.